Visit documentation complete and finalized. Proposed E and M level 99214. Do you wish to close the encounter?
Yes, please.
Dr. Davis, your next patient is in room 120. He presents for his annual physical exam and follow-up of hypertension. Recent encounters include one acute visit 2 months ago with your nurse practitioner for a sinus infection. He last saw you 8 months ago for hypertension follow-up. He has been reporting his home blood pressure readings monthly on the patient portal. Would you like to review those readings?
Yes, thank you, Iris.
Please note, Dr. Davis, the patient had a CBC done at his acute visit 2 months ago. The hematocrit had fallen 12% from his baseline. Attempts by staff to contact the patient for follow-up were unsuccessful.
Thank you for the heads up, Iris. Please remind me of that if I get sidetracked in there. By the way, what was his wife's name?
Grace.
Good to see you again, Mr. Lee.
Good to see you, Doctor.
It's been a little while.
Yeah.
How is Grace?
Oh, she's well. You know, our youngest just got married.
That's wonderful. I remember that she just got engaged the last time I saw you. Well, I see you're here for your annual checkup. Thank you for reviewing the medications and symptoms in the waiting room. Is this list correct?
Yeah, this looks right. Except I'm no longer taking the sinus medicine. And, oh yeah, by the way, I'm running low on the Atenolol.
Iris, can you remove the Loratadine from the medication list and renew Mr. Lee's Atenolol?
Mr. Lee, do you still prefer a 90-day supply to be sent from your mail-order pharmacy 4 times a year?
Yes.
Dr. Davis, Mr. Lee's blood pressure is 152 over 93. His pulse is 62 and regular. Do you wish to review before finalizing the prescription?
Yes, Iris. Mr. Lee, your blood pressure's a bit on the high side. And you can see, over the past few months, even at home, your blood pressure's been climbing steadily. Have you been taking the Atenolol and the Diavox?
Which one is the Diavox?
Diavox is the orange pill with the letters NVZ stamped on the side.
Oh, that's the one that I've been cutting in half.
Okay, let's increase the dose of the Diavox and have you take a full tablet every day. Your heart rate is nice and low already, so we'll keep you on the same Atenolol for now.
Dr. Davis, as of November 4, Mr. Lee's medical insurance will no longer cover Diavox. Would you like to substitute a different angiotensin II blocker?
Okay. How about the equivalent dose of Losartan?
Losartan 100 milligrams daily will be added to Mr. Lee's mail-order prescriptions.
Now, Mr. Lee, since we're changing your blood pressure medication, can you please check your blood pressure from your home monitor and transmit the readings to me on the patient portal once a week for the next 2 months?
Sure.
Iris, can you please schedule reminders for Mr. Lee on the patient portal?
Reminders scheduled.
Great. So, going back to the pre-visit questionnaire you completed, you mentioned increased constipation. Tell me more about that.
Well, it's probably nothing, but over the past few months, I've noticed my stool is getting darker. Sometimes it's even black.
Do you see red blood?
No, I haven't noticed any blood.
Have you ever had these symptoms before?
About 4 or 5 years ago, when I was with my previous primary care doctor, something like this came up, and he had me do a colonoscopy.
Do you remember what they found?
I think there was some kind of polyp, but I don't remember exactly what he said.
Iris, can you please access any outside records for any prior colonoscopies?
Mr. Lee's medical records release for HealthSmart Medical Group is on file. Mr. Lee had a colonoscopy performed 7 years ago, which revealed a low-grade adenomatous polyp. Dr. John Collier recommended repeat colonoscopy at 5 years. There is no record of any further colonoscopies.
Oh, gee, I guess I missed that one.
Don't feel badly. I bet that all happened about the time you moved, so I imagine it wasn't high on your priority list. By the way, do you have any family members with a history of colon cancer?
My sister had cancer.
History of colon cancer, an older sister at age 55.
Are you sure you're not experiencing any bleeding from the rectum, weight loss, or unusual fatigue?
Dr. Davis, at Mr. Lee's last office visit 2 months ago, he was seen by nurse practitioner Jennifer Adams for sinus pain, but at the time also complained of unusually dark stools. A CBC was ordered at that time.
That's right. The blood test showed your red blood cells had decreased. Iris, pull up that last visit and cue to the discussion about dark stools.
Aside from the sinus pain, have you noticed any other symptoms? Headache, fever?
No, not really.
Well, you know, maybe this doesn't mean anything, but my stomach has been acting crazy lately. Sometimes I have diarrhea, sometimes constipation, and a couple of times my stool was almost a black color. I've never seen it like that before.
How long have you had those symptoms?
I don't know, a couple of weeks. Anyway, it seems to be better now. I haven't noticed the black stools for a while.
You know what, all the same, why don't we check a CBC today to make sure that you're not anemic? Because sometimes dark stool can mean that there's blood in your GI tract.
Pause, play.
I completely forgot about that blood test. Of course, I was in so much agony with my sinuses that day. I don't even remember receiving the results. You know, I've been working a lot lately and traveling, and I guess I just haven't been so good about retrieving my messages.
Well, I'm glad we're following this up today. I think we ought to do a digital rectal exam as part of your physical, but I want to order a colonoscopy to check for polyps and a repeat CBC to make sure you're not more anemic. Iris, can you add the CBC and a reticulocyte count to today's lab order and pull up the colonoscopy schedule?
Dr. Davis, for medical necessity, please confirm the diagnosis is rectal bleeding and family history of colon cancer.
Yes.
Mr. Lee, the first available appointment on the main campus is next Thursday at 10 a.m. Would you like to schedule that time and date?
How about that one? I'm off work that day.
The procedure is scheduled, and a reminder message will be sent to your patient portal. Would you also like to have an invite sent to your email address and a text message reminder sent to your mobile phone prior to the appointment?
Yeah, sure. I guess that would make it easier for me to remember this time.
Iris, also please send education materials on GI screenings to Mr. Lee's portal account.
Education materials sent to patient portal.
Let's go ahead with the physical exam, and we'll order other tests depending on what we find in the exam. I'm glad I caught you, Mr. Lee. I was just reviewing my notes from your visit last week. And also, I just received the colonoscopy results from yesterday. Looks like you had a precancerous growth in your colon called a sessile polyp. It was big enough that it was causing quite a bit of blood loss, as well as those GI symptoms you've been describing. Fortunately, the gastroenterologist was able to remove the polyp, and we think that's going to take care of your problem. With your family history, I'm going to recommend we repeat that colonoscopy in 3 years.
What a relief. Thanks for catching that, Dr. Davis. I'll definitely follow up this time.
I'm keeping you to it. I'll have a reminder sent to you.
Reminder scheduled.
In the meantime, continue with your blood pressure medications and make sure to keep sending me those readings. The ones I see so far look like our changes are working.
Will do. Okay, Grace. No, it's the doctor. Thanks again for the good news, Dr. Davis. Anything else?
No, that's it. Bye now.
Non-face-to-face physician consultation documented and finalized. Proposed CPT code 99443. Do you wish to confirm and close the encounter?
Yes, please.
Dr. Davis, your daughter is calling on line 3.
Hi, sweetheart. Guess what? Mommy's done with her clinic.